are going to see your favorite subject, English. In English, we are going to revise a topic from grammar. The name of the topic is verb. What is the name of the topic, children? Verb. Along with that, we are going to revise how to write a letter. First, we will start with the verb. Before entering into the topic, let us see a girl named Nikki. How she is spending her vacation time. Nikki is into lot of actions on her holidays. Let us see what are the actions Nikki is doing. First, Nikki waters the plants. Next, she eats an apple. After that, she washes her bike. She writes a letter to her grandmother. Later, she goes to take a bath. Finally, she reads a book, children. Yes, see, children, how many actions Nikki is doing on her vacation. Okay, now let us move on to the topic, verb. What is today's topic, children? Verb. What are verbs?
Verbs are words that show an action. Verbs are words that show an action, children.
Yes. In first, I told you a story about a girl, Nikki. So now, you are going to find out what are the actions done by Nikki. First, what she is doing? Nikki waters the plants. In this, the action word is waters. So, waters is a verb, children. Action word. Second, what she is doing? She eats an apple. Yes, she is eating an apple. So, eating is an action word, children. Next,
she also washes her bike.
In this, which is the action word? Washes. Yes. Next, what she is doing? She writes a letter to her grandmother. In this sentence, which word is the action word, children? Writing. Yes. She writes a letter to her grandmother. Later, she goes to take a bath. In this sentence, we have two action words. What are they? Goes. She is going to take a bath. Even bath is an action word, children. Yes. Finally, she reads a book. So, read is an action word. What are verbs, children?
Verbs are words that show an action, children.
They are very important because they make a sentence complete. All action verbs are also called doing verbs. Action words can come from doing verbs. For example, to take, to fold, to fill, to clean. Now, let us see those doing words with examples. Ricky offers to take the dog for a walk. Ricky offers to take the dog for a walk. He offers to fold the clothes. He offers to fold the clothes. He also offers to fill the bottle with water. He also offers to fill the bottle with water. Best of all, he offers to clean the table after the dinner. Best of all, he offers to clean the table after the dinner. There are two types of verbs. What are they? Regular verbs, irregular verbs. What are they, children? Regular verbs, irregular verbs.
The verbs that end in ed or d is called regular verbs. The verbs that end in ed or d is called regular verbs, children.
For example, turn, turned. Turn, turned. What is the spelling of turn? T-U-R-N. Turned. T-U-R-N-E-D. So it ends with ed. So this is a regular verb. Next, play. P-L-A-Y, play. Played. P-L-A-Y-E-D. So this word also ends with ed, played. So played is also a regular verb, children.
The verbs that do not end in d or ed are called irregular verbs. The verbs that do not end in ed or d are called irregular verbs.
They change their spellings. For example, sleep, slept. Sleep, slept. S-L-E-E-P, sleep. But what is the spelling of slept? S-L-E-P-T. The spelling is changing over here. So, it is an irregular verb. Eat. E-A-T. Eat. E-A-T. Eat. A-T-E. Eat. See, here also the spelling is changing. A-T-E. Eat. So, this is also an irregular verb, children. I hope now you understood the difference between regular verb and irregular verb. Now, let us see an exercise related to regular and irregular verbs. By seeing the verbs used in each sentence, you are going to identify whether it is a regular verb or irregular verb, children. If it is a regular verb, mention as are. If it is an irregular verb, you are going to write IR. The first one, I ate an apple. What is the first one, children? I ate an apple. In this sentence, ate is the verb. So, ate is a regular verb or irregular verb, children? Yes, A-T-E. It is not ending with D or E-D. So, it is an irregular verb. So, in the first one, we are going to write I-R. I-R stands for irregular verb, children. Second one, Sanjay climbed the tree. In this, climbed is the verb. See the spelling of climbed? C-L-I-M-B-E-D. It is ending with E-D. So, it is a regular verb, children. The short form of regular is R. Yes, so we are going to write R. The third one, I slept late last night. In this sentence, which word is the verb, children? Yes, very good. Slept is the verb. What is the spelling of slept? S-L-E-P-T. Okay, so slept is the past tense of sleep. What is the spelling of sleep? S-L-E-E-P. So, here the spelling is changed. So, it is a irregular verb. So, we are going to write I-R. Fourth one, children. Ram studied science for 2 hours. Ram studied science for 2 hours. In this sentence, studied is the verb, children. The studied ends with E-D. The verb studied ends with ed, children. So it is a regular verb. So we are going to write r. Yes, the fifth one. Sunita sat on the chair. Sunita sat on the chair. The present tense of sat is sit. The spelling of sit is s-i-t. But here the spelling is s-a-t. So the spelling is change over here. So it is a irregular verb, children. I-R. Yes, the last one. Sixth one. My friend worked as a teacher. My friend worked as a teacher. Yes, in this sentence, worked is a verb. What is the spelling of worked? W-O-R-K-E-D, worked. It ends with E-D. So, it is a regular or irregular verb, children? Tell me. Yes, very good. It is a regular verb. So, we are going to write R. Yes, children, we have completed the verb. Now, let us see how to write a letter. So, it is time to revise how to write a letter, children. Shall we start? What is a letter? A letter is a form of communication. Children, what is meant by communication? Communication means to talk to someone or convey any message or information to some other person. We can share our thoughts, ideas, and experiences by writing a letter to a person who may be far away from us, children. Today, we are going to see how to write a formal letter. Shall we start, children? Yes, children. Now, I am going to teach you how to write a leave letter. Write a letter to your class teacher asking for leave. Now, we are going to write a letter. How we are going to start? First, you have to write the date, children. On which date you are writing the letter, you should write that date. Where you should write the date? You will be having your English classwork. In that is a four-line notebook. You have to write the date. Date should be in the right-hand side. Write the date. What date you are going to write? On which day you are writing the letter? Write that date, children. After writing the date, next what we are going to do? Near the margin, write from. Near the margin, you are going to write from. After from, put a comma. In the next line, write your name. In the next line, write your name. After writing the name, what you are going to do? Write your section. Second standard. And in second standard, you belong to which section? Write that section name. After that, school. Your school name. A verb in? Your school name you have to write, children. After that, write area. Write the name of the area which you belong to. After writing the area, write Chennai. Chennai. After writing Chennai, you should write your PIN code also, children. Yes? Yes, children. Now you have to write to. To whom you are writing the letter? To your class teacher. So after writing to, put a comma. In the next line, write the class teacher. After that, write ever when your school name. After that, area. Write the area where your school is located. After that, Chennai. After that, what you are going to write? Chennai. After writing Chennai, write the PIN code of your school area where it is located. Yes, children? After completing two, what we are going to write? Respected madam. After writing respected madam, what you should do, children? You should put a comma. Children, in from and to, in all the places, you should put comma. After writing your PIN code, what you are going to do? You are going to keep a full stop.
Yes, children, will you all do that?
Now, respected madam. After writing respected madam, put a comma. In the next line, from the margin, leave two fingers of gap. Keep your two fingers and after that, start writing as I am running, high temperature, I am unable to come to school. So, I request you to kindly accept my absence and grant right? So now what we are going to write? As I am running high temperature, I am unable to come to school. After school, we are going to keep a full stop. Now, after school, a full stop, we have kept. So, right? So, after so, we should put a comma, children. So, I request you to kindly accept my absence and grant me leave for 3 days. We are going to write the date. What date we are going to write? From which day you want leave? In the first blank, you are going to write the starting date of your leave, children. After that, write 2. In the second blank, you are going to write the ending date of your leave, children. After writing the date, keep full stop, children. Yes, we have completed the content of the letter. In the next line, write thanking you. After writing thanking you, put a comma, children. In the next line, write yours obediently. What you are going to write? Yours obediently. After that, put a comma. After writing yours obediently, move on to the next line. Then what we are going to write? You should write your name, children. After writing your name, keep a full stop. Yes, so we have completed the letter. What is written in the letter? What do you mean by high temperature, children? That you are having a high fever. So, you are not able to go to school. So, you are requesting your class teacher to accept your absence and grant you leave for 3 days. Yes? So, you all will complete the letter, children? Yes, children. Now, let us see an example of writing a letter which is given in a grammar textbook. Yes, page number 76. Nikki wants to write a letter to a friend, but she is not sure where to begin. Mrs. John tells her the steps in writing a proper letter. A girl named Nikki wants to write a letter to a friend, but she doesn't know how to write a letter. Now, who is going to guide her? Mrs. John is going to teach her how to write a proper letter. Come, let us also join along with them. Read and follow the instructions to learn about letter writing. Think about what is your purpose for writing the letter. First, before writing the letter, you should think for what purpose you are going to write the letter. Do you want to thank someone? First one, do you want to thank someone? Second one, do you want to ask for something? Third one, do you want to invite somebody? Fourth one, do you want to write to a friend? See, maybe your purpose can be from any one of these four, or even you can write a letter to some other, or it may be some other purpose, children. For writing a letter, you will need an envelope. The first one is an envelope. Second one, paper. Third one, a postal stamp. The fourth one is word in sentences. Fifth one, a post box. Your letter will need, first one, your address and date of writing. Second one, greetings of the receiver, dear. Third one, body, information or message you want to share. Fourth one, closing, a way to say goodbye. Fifth one, your name or signature. All these 5 is very important to write a letter, children. This is Nikki's letter to a friend who moved to another school. B. 2 not 2. Yashodeep Vasova Road, Mumbai, October 26, 2013. First in letter she has written the address, after that she has written the month, date and the year. Next one, greetings. Dear Bulbul, how are you? I miss you a lot. You are my best friend. I wish you would come back. I hope you like your new school and make new friends. What is the name of your school? What is your new teacher's name? Do you miss me? When will you come and visit me? Yes, this is the body of the letter, children. Now, the conclusion of the letter. Please reply soon. Yes, after writing the letter, your friend Nikki, she has written her name. Now, write your letter here. Now, it's time to write a letter on your own. You can write a letter to your friend or relatives, to whomever you like. Yes, children, I hope you all will do it. After completing the letter, what we will do? We have to post the letter. Now, let us see how to write address on the envelope. Read the given instructions to write the address on the envelope. Receiver's address. Where we should write the receiver's address, children? On the front side of the envelope, where the postal stamp will be pasted. 2. First, you should write 2. Name of the person. Under 2, the name of the person. Under the name of the person, house address. In the next, you should write street name. After street name, come down. Now write the city and pin code. At last, you should write the state. Now, you should write the sender's address. Where you are going to write the sender's address? At the back side of the envelope. In the sender's address, you should write first from. Under the from, write your name. Next, after your name, come down, write house address. After that, write the street name. Under the street name, next we are going to write city and pin code. Yes, at last you are going to write the street.
Yes, children, will you all write a letter and try to post it in the same way?
Receiver address. What is the meaning of receiver address, children? The address of the person to whom you are writing the letter. Sender's address. What is the meaning of sender's address? Now you are going to write a letter. So you should write your address. Yes, children, now it is recap time. நம்ம இன்னைக்கு என்ன சப்ஜெக்ட் பார்த்தோம்? இங்கிலீஷ். இங்கிலீஷ்ல இருந்து நம்ம இன்னைக்கு என்ன ரிவைஸ் பண்ணோம்? கிராமர். கிராமர்ல இருந்து ஒரு டாபிக்கை நம்ம ரிவைஸ் பண்ணோம். என்ன டாபிக்? வெர்ப். வெர்ப்னா என்ன? ஆக்சன் வேர்ட்ஸ் தான் வெர்ப்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. ஆக்சன் வேர்ட்னா என்ன? ரைட்டிங், சிங்கிங், டான்சிங், எழுறது, பாடுறது, ஆடுறது, இது எல்லாமே என்னது? ஆக்சன் வேர்ட்ஸ். ஓகே, வெர்ப்லயே ரெண்டு வகை இருக்கு. என்னது? ரெகுலர் வெர்ப், இர்ரெகுலர் வெர்ப். ஒரு வேர்டோட சிம்பிள் பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ். இப்ப வெர்ப்னா அந்த சிம்பிள் பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ் என்னது? வொர்க்ட். அது இடில முடியுது. இப்ப ஒரு வேர்டோட சிம்பிள் பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ் டி இல்ல இடில முடிஞ்சா அது வந்து ரெகுலர் வெர்ப். ஒரு வேர்டோட சிம்பிள் பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ் டி இல்ல இடில முடியாம அதோட ஸ்பெல்லிங்கே மாறி வந்ததுன்னா அதுதான் இர்ரெகுலர் வெர்ப். ஈட். ஈட்டோட பாஸ்ட் டென்ஸ் என்னது? ஏட். ஏடி. அப்ப இது டிலயோ இல்ல இடிலயோ முடியல. அப்ப இந்த மாதிரி வர வேர்ட்ஸ் தான் இர்ரெகுலர் வெர்ப், சில்ட்ரன். அதுக்கப்புறம் நம்ம என்ன பார்த்தோம்? ஒரு லெட்டர் எப்படி எழுதுறதுங்கிறத ரிவைஸ் பண்ணோம். ரெண்டு விதமான லெட்டர் பார்த்தோம். ஒண்ணு வந்து ஃபார்மல் லெட்டர், இன்னொன்னு இன்ஃபார்மல் லெட்டர். Yes children, I hope you all enjoyed today's session. Let us meet in our next session. Take care. Thank you children.